So a common question people have concerning photos and their iPhone is how can they remove photos from their iPhone because they're running out of space. They have a lot of photos and they notice they're running short on space on their iPhone and they want to remove photos from their iPhone but they want to keep them in their iCloud photo library. They don't want to delete them forever. They just don't want to have them with them in their pocket all the time. So a typical setup you may have is you may have say a Mac and an iPhone and you turn on iCloud photo library. And this is great because say if you have 10,000 photos taking up 20 gigs of space then you'll find that all the photos are on both your devices. However, you're starting to run out of space on your iPhone so you want to clear out some of those photos. Well, if you try to delete a photo, of course it's going to give you a warning saying this is going to delete the photo from everywhere, which isn't what you want. So what's the solution? Well, the solution is just a simple switch. You see, if you go into Settings on your iPhone and then you go into Photos, there's a switch there between Optimize iPhone Storage and Download and Keep Originals. Now if you have the check mark next to Download and Keep Originals, that means every photo you take on your iPhone is going to remain on your iPhone full resolution, the full thing. Matter of fact, any photo that you then take from a camera and put onto your Mac or take from some other device like an iPad and store in your iCloud photo library is also going to download and be on your iPhone. Your iPhone is going to have a complete library of all your photos at full high resolution. But if you select Optimize iPhone Storage, then what you're going to get is a mix. And this is what you want. For instance, going back to this chart here, you see you have 10,000 photos and they're stored taking up the same amount of space on your Mac as on your iPhone. But if you turn on Optimize iPhone Storage, you'll get this. You still get all your photos on your Mac, but on your iPhone you may have something like this where you have say 2,000 photos taking up 4 gigs of space are full high resolution and 8,000 photos are only thumbnails. In other words, you can still see them in there but the full high resolution versions aren't there anymore. Matter of fact, the versions you see on your phone are much smaller, much more compressed. So they only take up a fraction of the space. So now instead of taking up 20 gigs of space, it's taking up 4 plus gigabytes of space. And it looks like you still have all 10,000 photos. Now what happens when you want to view a photo? Well, when you go to view a photo and it's not one of those that you have on your iPhone that's already there as full resolution, then what you'll get is this thumbnail version of it. And if you go to zoom in on it, it's going to need the higher resolution version of it. And it's going to try to download it. And you'll see a little circle there at the bottom fill up as it downloads that photo. And then once you have the full one, you can see the full resolution. You notice the trees here, they're much crisper now that I have the full resolution photo on my iPhone. So when it's set like this, how is it decided what 2,000 photos you've got full resolution and what 8,000 you don't? And these are just sample numbers. The 2,000 is going to represent your most recent photos, the ones you've just taken, and the ones you've just viewed. So it's going to kind of use some sort of intelligence there to figure out which ones to keep. And say you want to view some photos, say you view an album and you look at 10 photos, it might change like this. You get 10 more photos, right, stored full resolution and the rest are still not stored on the iPhone. Now, after time goes by, you may find that it changes and you have even less stored. You don't really see a number there. It's kind of doing this automatically in the background. Maybe it identifies photos you haven't looked at in a long time and that you need space to store apps and other things. So it's going to adjust that. It's all going to happen automatically. There's nothing you need to do. It's going to look at how much storage space you've got left. So someone with a ton of space, like 100 gigs available on their iPhone, may find that they have a lot more full resolution versions already on their iPhone because there's space there. So it might as well store them. And someone who's running short on space may find there's only a handful of photos there that are full resolution. And that every time you go to look at an older photo, it's going to have to download it in order for you to zoom in. Now, if you look here just to see this in action, here is my iPhone storage. And you can notice there that it shows under Photos that I've got 5.36 gigabytes of photo storage. Well, that's really something because if you look at my Mac, there's the photo library. It's the same library. This is my iCloud Photos library. And you see it's 109 gigabytes. That's the actual size with all the high resolution photographs. So you can see it saved me quite a bit of space, because if I had turned on have the full resolution versions here, then I'd have to store 109 gigs on my iPhone. Now you can also do the same thing on your Mac. You can go into either System Preferences and iCloud, or it's easier if you just go into Photos Preferences and then iCloud, and you can turn on Optimize Mac Storage instead of Download Originals to this Mac. And why would you want to do this? Well, I like the idea of keeping all my photos on my desktop Mac, so I have all my photos here stored locally. You don't have to. All the high resolution photos are going to always be on iCloud. So it is possible, if you're short on storage on your Mac and your iPhone, to have Optimize turned on both and have high resolution versions only on Apple servers. But as it turns out, I've got two Macs. I have a desktop Mac and a laptop Mac. And my laptop Mac doesn't have a very big hard drive in it. So I've turned this Optimize Mac storage on my laptop Mac. And the photos library there, again, it's the same photos library. It's shared because it's all part of my iCloud photo library. You can see it's only taking up 24 gigs of space. I probably view a lot more photos on my laptop than I do on my phone, and there's a lot of extra space left over, so it's storing more there. If I was running out of space, I bet you those 24 gigs would go down closer to the 5 gigs that I have on my iPhone. We'll be right back.